church. It's so good to see all your smiling faces this morning. If you were visiting with us this morning and have not before put a visitor card in, if you could fill one of those out and put it in the offering tray when it comes around later on in the service. The rest of our announcements will be at the end of the service today. So let's prepare our hearts and our minds for worship.
Thank you. hymnbook. And what do we call Jesus' hymnbook? Was called what? The
Bible.
Well, which book in the Bible? The Psalms. The book of the Psalms is the Hebrew songbook. And so this is something I'm going to give you to when you go to your class. I have this envelope. I'm going to let Miles, if you'll give that to your teacher, and at the end of the class, you're going to get a little verse like this. Can you read it with me? God will cover you.
Thank you.
Shotwell and Dixie Tripp.
Sharon Tower.
Marsha Richardson.
Lord, we give you thanks for each of those we have named today, for the ways they have impacted each of us and guided us that we might be part of your church, for the ways in which they have impacted their community, for the ways in which they have spread your kingdom. We give you thanks, O Lord. We commend their souls unto you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. We've now come to our time for sharing of joys and concerns. I have a few updates. Continued prayers for Kathy Jones. She did have a successful procedure this past week, but is still having a few problems, so please keep Kathy in your prayers. Prayers for Bob Weber, who had a fall this past Wednesday and is in the ICU at Lewis Gale. And a joy and thanksgiving for David Brown. David came up here and hung out in a little bitty hole up here behind the baptistry for a little over an hour on Monday, but we do have our heating system back working in our baptistry. Probably good that Nicole and Alex aren't here right now, or they may just be me. But a big thank you to David for that work, coming out and doing that. We have, also from the Unity class, prayers for Buck Shepherd, Tom Harris, Nancy Gallimore, Sandy Whitley, Peggy Thompson, Jane Hurst, Jackie Reynolds, and two unspoken requests. We have joys or concerns to share from the congregation. Mary?
I've got a joy, which final closing on our house in Florida is this coming weekend on the 10th. And I've got two concerns. My uncle, Alvin Mitchell, took a fall, and he's in his head and has confusion and mobility issues suddenly. He was in really good health. And then my dad still is doing real well with his mobility.
And what's his name again?
Charles. Charles O'Dell.
So good news for Brett and Mary. They're finally going to sell the house in Florida this coming weekend. The prayers for Alvin Mitchell, who hit his head and is having some confusion, and for Charles O'Dell. Stacy.
We have Chris Branning, joy. Chris Branning celebrated her 96th birthday yesterday.
Oh, goodness. Wonderful. What's her name?
Edith Harrison.
Edith Harrison. Celebrated her 96th birthday yesterday. Yes, Anis.
Paige Eaton.
Prayers for Paige Eaton. Jared?
I continue prayers for Doris Carter. And for good news, I got news from my grandson, Aaron, and his wife. In the spring, we'll have another boy.
Jared will be a great grandfather once again. Congratulations to Jerry and to Aaron, Britton, and his family. Others? Yes.
Lisa in prayers, Candy Ewers. She's scheduled to go to the Blue Ridge Cancer Center this week. She's had some issues with the meeting.
Prayers for Candy Ewers.
W-E-R-S. Ewers.
Okay, Ewers. Mm-hmm. Who's having some problems with anemia. Yes, Cindy.
My neighbor Sharon, who lost her husband Alex in April. Her brother had a brain aneurysm and passed away suddenly in Richmond. His name is Tom Hines.
Prayers for the Hines family, his son passing this week. Yeah, Christy?
I had a friend who passed away on Friday from cervical cancer. And her name was Valerie Grooms. And I just wanted some prayers for her family. She has an 18-year-old daughter, and I know she's heartbroken. And
the Grooms family, Valerie, passed away on Friday from cervical cancer and has an 18-year-old daughter, so prayers for their family. Yes, Freeman.
Gloria Witt. Gloria.
Gloria Witt. Thank you, Freeman. Yeah, Amanda?
A 2-year-old little girl, Lily, is in the hospital today
with croup. Lily is in the hospital, 2 years old, with croup. Yes, Sandy?
White Lily.
Joe Ogle. His mother passed away last night.
Prayers for Joe Ogle and the Ogle family. His mother passed away last night. Yes, Bobby?
Continue prayers for Ron, Adama, and Nelson, and
her family. For Don Perlman, her dad, and the whole family. He is up on a walker now, which is an atonement.
Yes.
But continue prayers for them. Yeah, Alice?
Congratulations to the Wynn and Perry family. Their children were married last night. It's Hall Wynn, daughter of Hal and Lone, that we assisted and supported in their times when they came here to America from Vietnam. And she married Dr. James Perry.
Congratulations to Hal Wynn, who was a refugee from Vietnam that we helped a couple decades ago, who was married last night to a Dr. Perry. Yeah, Ellen?
I just like to kind of remind everyone that we have missionaries that really don't cry. It really doesn't matter what country they're in. They're all good with us.
Prayers for our missionaries. Yeah.
Ben?
Yes, Jesus.
Reverend Jim Dickerson, who was pastor of Bethany Christian Church back in the 70s before moving to Martinsville, he died this past week. Services for
Prayers for the Dickerson family, Reverend Jim Dickerson, who was a pastor of Bethany and Vernon, passed away this past week. Other joys and concerns. Let's go together to God in prayer. Lord, your Spirit moves among us even when we are not aware of it. We give you thanks that it has moved through the centuries, that it continues to move today, and that it guides us to be part of your work. Lord, we lift up each of those we have named here today into your care. Kathy Jones, Bob Weber, David Brown, Buck Shepherd, Tom Harris, Nancy Gallimore, Sandy Whitley, Peggy Thompson, Jane Hurst, Jackie Reynolds, the Phillips family, Alvin Mitchell, Charles Odell, Edith Harrison, Paige Eaton, Doris Carter, Aaron Britton and his family, Tammy Uris, the Hines family, the Grooms family, Gloria Witt, Lily, Mike Whitley, Joe Ogle, Donna Perlman, the Wynn and Perry family, our missionaries around the world, and the Dickerson family. Lord, we lift these up to you, trusting in your care, knowing your goodness. We pray this in your Son, Jesus Christ's name, as we pray together the words that he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. The Lord has gathered us around this table. Not only those of us who are present here today, but those who have gone before us, and those who are present in his body around the world. We gather here with all the saints of all time to partake in Christ's body and blood, to proclaim his salvation and his good news. Let's prepare for our time of communion as we stand together and sing our communion hymn. Gather us in. Let's stand and sing.
Here in this place, the new light is streaming.
night that Christ was betrayed. But during supper, he took a loaf of bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, saying, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat of it in remembrance of me."
Let us pray. We gather here at this table of Holy Communion. We give thanks for this opportunity as we partake of this bread of life. May it awaken us to seize opportunities day by day, moment by moment, within these doors, our community, and beyond. Amen.
Thank you.
must obey them and do everything they tell you. But do not do what they do, for they do not practice what they preach. They tie up heavy loads and put them on men's shoulders, but they themselves are not willing to lift a finger to move them. Everything they do is done for men to see. They make their phylacteries wide and the tassels on their garments long. They love the place of honor at banquets and the most important seats in synagogues. They love to be greeted in the marketplaces and to have men call them rabbi. But you are not to be called rabbi, for you have only one master, and you are all brothers. And do not call anyone on earth father, for you have one Father, and he is in heaven. Nor are you to be called teacher, for you have one teacher, the Christ. The greatest among you will be your servant. For whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and whoever humbles himself will be exalted. Woe to you, teachers of the laws and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You shut the kingdom of heaven in men's faces. You yourself do not enter, nor will you let those enter who are trying to. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So on Thursday, Oliver got sick. And you all know what it's like to have a sick three-year-old. It's very painful, it's tough, and Friday I was home with him. We didn't let him go to preschool because he was running a fever, and he was just puny and pathetic all day Friday. I mean, just laying on the couch, didn't want to do anything, just felt terrible for him. Finally, Friday afternoon, I said, okay, let's get outside and get a little fresh air. We'll just go sit on the front porch for a few minutes, and he kind of whispered, okay, because he didn't have a voice. And we went and we sat on the front porch, and after about 15 or 20 minutes, he had perked up just a little bit, but I think he was ready to go back inside. He said, can we go inside? And I said, okay, we'll go inside. And I stood up and I looked down the street as I was getting ready to go inside, and I realized his little friend Grayson, who's another three-year-old that goes to preschool with him, and Grayson's parents and one of his grandparents were coming up the street. And I said, well, do you want to wait and say hi to Grayson? He said, yeah. So we waited, and Grayson and his family get up the street and stop in our driveway and are saying, you know, we noticed Oliver wasn't, Grayson told us Oliver wasn't in preschool this morning. Is he okay? I said, no, he's feeling a little bit sick. And about this time, I noticed Grayson, he's on his little balance bike, which is a bike without pedals. He's just standing there. He kind of looks up at his dad, like really concerned when he heard that Oliver was sick. And I thought, wow, what empathy. That's wonderful. And his dad looked down at him, and Grayson just kind of kept looking at him, and his dad said, well, Grayson, buddy, do you want to say a prayer for Oliver? And Grayson immediately put his face in his hands, which is maybe the most adorable way to pray ever, is a three-year-old with their face in their hands. And he said, dear God, please let Oliver get better and have a good day. In Jesus' name, amen. And they went on their way, and Oliver and I went back into our house. Grayson's dad is Chris, and Chris is the pastor of Grace Covenant Church over on Peters Creek, and Chris and I have kind of gotten to be pretty good friends over the last year or so, and I've got to tell you, Chris doesn't have any seminary training. He felt called to the ministry, and his church kind of took him up, and he has learned under the leadership of some other ministers within a group of churches as he has become a pastor. And I've got all this seminary training. I've got an undergraduate degree in religion. I have presented at national conferences. I've got a seminary master's of divinity degree, which I think might be the coolest master's you can get. But I was absolutely humbled, because I don't know that my three-year-old, had the roles been reversed, would have thought to pray. It's easy to get caught up in degrees and education and all of that stuff. It's easy to get caught up in adults being smart and knowing what they're doing and all of that. But what it takes is just a moment for a three-year-old to say, dear God, please let Oliver feel better and have a good day. In Jesus' name, amen. We as Christians have one Lord. one Savior, and the rest of us are on equal footing. The rest of humanity is put on equal footing by Christ saying, look, we're all sinners, but we're also all beloved children of God. We're all forgiven. We're all welcome around this table. But humans want to have people who are in charge, people who are important, people who teach us, people who lead us, people who are righteous. And we set up our societies in this way, and in the end, we end up even in the disciples' church where we say, all of us are ministers. There is the priesthood of all believers. We still find ourselves saying, okay, but that person is probably a little bit more righteous than everybody else. We hold up our minister or our elders or our deacons or our board to a higher standard when we all should be held to the same standard. But here's the thing, is that standard is so simple and so easy. When you see someone who's in need, someone who's hurting, someone you can offer help to or a prayer for, you do it. It goes back to our task for last week. Love the Lord your God with all your mind and all your heart and all your strength. And love your neighbor as you love yourself. It's that simple. We can all live up to that if we're willing to do it. Jesus in his day obviously had the same kinds of struggles. He saw the Pharisees. He said, they sit up on Moses' seat, and so therefore you have to listen to them. But don't do what they do. Because they're far more interested in sitting in Moses' seat and showing off how holy they are. Showing off the fact that they know what a phylactery is. Who in here knows what a phylactery is? You of you know what a phylactery is. Some of you are putting your hands up like real low so that I don't call on you to answer the question. Here's the thing, I'm not even going to tell you, because it doesn't matter what a phylactery is. Y'all are sitting there waiting for the answer. It doesn't matter what a phylactery is, it matters do we love God with all our heart and all our mind and all our strength, and do we love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Jesus said they want to tie up heavy burdens on you, because in doing that they can bar the door to the kingdom of God. They have come to realize that they need to be the ones in control. They refuse to allow the entry that God would have us have into the kingdom of God. And so they make it hard. They make it so you have to know what a phylactery is. They make it so you have to be righteous all the time. You have to be perfect in order to get into the kingdom of God. You have to follow all 300 some odd laws that there are in the Old Testament to get into the kingdom of God. You have to do. And it's complicated. I don't even know what that law means. Like, how far can I walk on the Sabbath? Anybody know?
2 miles,
quarter mile, maybe. Here's the thing. We don't even know how their units of measurement translate into ours, so let's just forget it. Here's the thing. We get caught up in all of that stuff, and we make it so complex and so hard, and that's what people who want to put themselves over you do. They want you to have to go to them to understand how to get closer to God. Jesus is flattening it out. He's saying there's no one who can tell you how to get to God except Jesus Christ. It's that simple. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your mind, and all your strength. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. It's that simple. You don't need phylacteries. You don't need long tassels on your robes. You don't even need robes. This is the point in the sermon where I take my robe off, except I don't want y'all to know my secret identity as Superman. Is it that unbelievable? Stuff. We don't need the big words. We don't need to have the education. That doesn't mean education doesn't have a place, because the more we learn, the better we can do. But education should not bar us from the kingdom of God. Knowing what a phylactery is, or how far we can walk on the Sabbath, or what kind of animal we need to make of it, what kind of sacrifice for what kind of sin, all of that stuff just makes it harder to get into the kingdom of God. When we learn only from Jesus Christ. From his teachings, and from his spirit. The rest of the stuff will be revealed to us as we have need for it. We can sit in class and learn all day long about all of the things in the Bible, and I'm not saying the Bible is unimportant, but when we know the Bible well, it does not mean in any way, shape, or form that we will live our lives as Christians. Jesus said, even devil, even the demons, can quote scripture. It is how you follow Jesus Christ.
simple ways. Are we willing to do that? Are we able to do that? It's not complicated. You don't have to know what a phylactery is, but it doesn't hurt to know sometimes. Go and do, living as though you are already in the kingdom of God, loving to God with all your heart, all your mind, and all your strength, and all your soul, loving your neighbor as you love yourself. Last week I told y'all I want to hear your stories about what that looks like. I shared mine. I got to see a three-year-old loving God with all his heart, all his mind, and all his strength because he turned to prayer in that moment of need. And loving his neighbor, his friend Oliver, as he loved himself, he was confident enough, even as a three-year-old, to say a prayer. Where have you seen God moving in that, in your life? Go and live it out again this week. Amen. If there is anyone here today who has not before made a profession of faith in Jesus Christ, the one who opened the doors to the kingdom of heaven for all to enter in, we invite you to come forward and do so. If there is anyone who would like to join together with this body of Christ as we seek to welcome more into the kingdom of God, we invite you to come forward and do so. And if there is anyone who would like to rededicate their life, who would like to say, yes, I want to do the simple things well, we invite you to come forward and do so. As we stand together and sing our hymn of invitation, let's stand and sing.
Thank you.
time to look through this announcement sheet. I'm going to highlight a number of things, but I won't hit everything. Please take time to look through it and to sign up. Sign-up sheets are out in the gathering area on the bulletin board here and around the corner. First off, we have our cabinet meeting immediately following worship. This is for all of our ministry leaders and those who are involved in the day-to-day activities of our ministries. If you can please join together, we'll be down in the Hearts and Souls Room, Bill's Sunday School class. This Wednesday, November 8th, we have our Over 55 breakfast at 9 a.m. at Famous Anthony's. On Saturday, our volunteers will be going to the Ram House. Carol, do you still need folks?
Okay,
Carol says we've got enough. But here's a little thing we can also do. Take this sheet and look at it. See what ministries are active during the week. Even if you can't be involved with them, take a moment on the day they're happening to pray for those who are doing them. So that's a great start for that. Also, a reminder that the Ram House, as part of its 30th anniversary, is doing a fundraiser. It's asking for a $30 donation from 300 individuals to help with its operational costs. If you would like to give, you can write a check and put it in our offering tray. You can give by Givelify. Just make sure you put in the memo line, Ram House. Next Sunday after church, Stacey Harrison is going to be leading a class on the use of our AED device. Please, if you have a chance to get trained in this, we hope we never have a use for it, but if we have a use for it, if we have a need for it, we need as many people as possible to be trained on it so that we have the person here who could do it if we need it. Don't forget to sign up for the praise team. That schedule has started filling up some, but please make sure to sign up for that. November 17th and 18th, it's getting here quick, folks, the yard sale. Contact Betty Richardson. Betty, it's time for your little wave right there. If you've got stuff we can start collecting, please let us know, and we will get by to see you as soon as possible. The Praiseworthy and Disciple Players will be performing a benefit concert. I've talked about this for a few weeks. It's November 24th, the Friday after Thanksgiving. Please plan on coming out, and we'll take up a love offering during it to help support the general ministries of our church. On the way to church this morning on the radio, I heard there's a station playing Christmas music. That sounds like, to some people, it might be a little early because it's still several weeks to Thanksgiving. But in church, we have to start planning pretty early to get ready for all of our Christmas stuff. We have two big activities in terms of Christmas this year. We've got our Pancakes with St. Nick on December 9th. Children, adults, you know, we've had folks from 0 to 99 sitting on St. Nick's lap down there. So please plan on coming out for that. It's a wonderful time. And then we've got our Christmas program, which will have two parts. Three parts, actually. We'll have a children's Christmas pageant. If your children want to be involved, please sign them up on the sign-up sheet out in the gathering area. It's going to be pretty simple rehearsals beforehand, but please go ahead and get signed up for that. In between the Christmas pageant and the cantata, we're going to actually have a nice music video being put together by the folks who did Lamb of God several years ago. And then we'll have our Christmas cantata. And Danita is asking anyone to sign up to sing in the choir or to come out on Wednesday nights to sing in the choir who's interested in helping sing in the cantata. It doesn't mean you're here every Sunday morning to sing with the choir. It's a special opportunity. And I know, at least I've heard from a little birdie, that Wren Prilliman has joined the choir for the Christmas cantata. So come and join and have fun with that. In January, we will have Resurrection, our trip for our youth. If your children are interested in going, please talk to Vicki Richardson and get signed up as soon as possible. So we want to get the whole group signed up together and registered together. So let Vicki know ASAP if your kids are interested in going. And then the final announcement, who read their newsletter last week? Okay, we've got a few. We've got a good group. Okay. If you read your newsletter, you know that I am pushing hard for the entire church to do a book study together for the next year. It sounds like a long ways, but this is an opportunity for us to draw closer to the Holy Spirit, to learn more about what the Holy Spirit is, what it does in our lives, how it's active, how it's already been active, and how we can know it better as we make decisions in our lives. If you would like to receive a book, if you can't order it yourself, it is available on Amazon, but if you want me to order one for you, I've got a sign-up sheet up in the gathering area. It just says, book order, sign up. Sign up and I will order you a book. The books are $12. You'll give that money either in the offering tray, Mark, or to Bobby Morris. I try try not to handle the money if at all possible. But this is an opportunity for us as a church to take seriously the part of the Holy Spirit, the part of the Trinity that Christ said would be left for us to guide us, to comfort us, and to help us to live our faith out. And I think it's an opportunity for us as a church to really get close to it. So I hope everyone will get a book. Even if you can't make it to one of the studies, and I'm going to add a couple extra studies in, please sign up and get a book and do the study along with us. There will also be prayer prompts and things like that starting in December for us to pray together as a church. And I think it's going to be a wonderful year. So please sign up for any of those things and have a wonderful and blessed week. Thank you. Yes, Ellen. The latest we could order and have it to you in time for December 3rd would be the Sunday before, which I think is December or November 26th. So sign up by November 26th, but the sooner the better, because I can get the book into your hands. Thank you. Have a blessed day.